I'm afraid I cannot speak in Korean, but I do have the text on the slides, and I think it's also in Korean. So thank you very much for the introduction. Thank you to Startup Alliance for organizing this great event. What I'm going to be talking about today is marketing and communications. Now, as mentioned, PR. PR is obviously a part of marketing communications, and this is what we're doing at G3, a company that I founded at the beginning of last year. So obviously, these days, Korean startups want to go global. That's obvious, that's a need for almost all startups. And it's no surprise, because the only way to achieve massive success these days is really through massive scale, and that means going global. And this is really what we're trying to do with Korean startups, helping them expand outside of Korea. But the question is always, how do you achieve massive scale with very minimal resources? People like Steve Jobs did it. This is the garage where he founded Apple. And this is, again, what we're trying to help Korean startups with. So we always encourage startups, when they're thinking about going global, to first set a number of clear, very simple business goals that they're trying to achieve. You cannot take over the world from day one, so it's always about taking small steps to massive success. Some of the goals could look like this here at the bottom. For example, acquire 200,000 users in the US by the beginning of next year, or hit a certain specific revenue target. So once you have a small number of clear business goals, the next thing is to design a simple marketing and communication strategy that helps you directly supports those business goals. So again, focusing on a specific market or a specific target customer. And for the rest of this presentation, that's what I'm going to be focusing on. Talking about three simple, cost-effective, high-impact strategies that most startups with limited resources can actually implement. So a few assumptions up front. These four assumptions are normally what we would look for in a Korean startup that's looking to go global. So you have to have a great product. If you don't have a great product, it's very difficult to achieve massive scale. Having a great website or having information in a relevant language is also extremely important. If people cannot find out what you're doing through an online search, it's going to be very difficult to market your product. Money is also important. Now, the strategies I'll talk about won't require tons of money, but you do need some money, and obviously if you're expanding overseas, you'll need to potentially hire overseas, you'll need money for marketing and advertising. So the companies that we typically work with have raised their Series A or their Series B funding, and are using that specifically to expand overseas for the first time. And it's also extremely useful to have someone employed overseas. Now, that could be someone from your Korean HQ who's posted overseas to help kick off your global efforts, or even better, hiring someone locally. So if you're expanding to Singapore, hiring a Singaporean is a very good way to kick off your business. So, you're ready for launch, you're ready to try and hit this J-curve in your new market, and the following three slides will identify three marketing strategies, marketing and communication strategies that you can kick off. So, first thing, holding a press event to launch your service in a new market is a good way to start. Now, many startups think that a press event, a press conference, looks something like this here on the left. Five-star hotel, you know, hundreds of people, all of the top journalists from all the top publications, huge costs, lots of organization. It doesn't need to be like this. We've organized very small scale press conferences with just a small handful of journalists. The last one we did was in a bar in Itaewon, where we invited a small number of foreign journalists. The result was around 50 articles published in 7 different languages, just off one event that we organized in about 3 or 4 days. So forget about the 5-star, think simple, think impact. Number 2, once you've generated some media interest and you've let writers make an assessment of your product or service in your new market, a good idea is to follow it up with your own story. Now, many publications will accept contribution posts from entrepreneurs if you've got an interesting story to tell and you're contacting a relevant publication. It's relatively easy to get published. Obviously, for Asia, lots of our clients have written guest posts which are published on Tech in Asia. If Southeast Asia is one of your target markets, it's a great way to get some additional exposure. And if you have a good writer in your startup, you can do it for free. The third thing we normally recommend is building momentum on these first 2 strategies through a combination of offline and online activity. So if you're launching in a new market, really getting to understand your customers in your new market is really important. Holding a small monthly or even quarterly meetup with some of your key customers can help you build a great relationship with some of your most important customers. It also gives you a lot of material that you can use to syndicate onto online channels. Those channels could be social media, your Facebook page, you might want to write a monthly blog on your company company website, or even use that as material to get additional contribution articles. But the key point here is building a relationship with your customers in your new market through an offline event, and then bringing the content from that offline event online. So that's 3 communication strategies that most startups can implement. They're generally high impact, relatively low cost, and it's something that you can organize fairly quickly and easily. These are also things that you can repeat on a biannual basis. So for example, every 6 months, you might have a product update and you hold another small press event. That also obviously helps to build relationships with writers. And in the last few minutes, just 3 more tips. There's actually 4. I'm not very good at math, but I am very good at writing. So we've got 4 tips for you. Right, so clear, concise, compelling, and consistent content. Whenever you're doing any kind of communication activity, bear these things in mind. It's really important. If your marketing team is giving a different message on your social media channels compared to what your CEO is talking about at a conference, it'll confuse the market. Your messaging should be clear, concise, keep things short and simple. And it doesn't matter which channel, whether it's on social media, whether you're speaking at a conference, or getting an article published. Many tech startups are obsessed with their technology. Most of their customers are not. So when you are, especially when you're reaching out to customers, it's different with investors, of course, but with customers, most of them don't care about your technology. They care about how your product or service makes their life better and how much it costs. So with your communication, focus on that. Don't focus so much on your technology. Second tip is obviously dream big. Everyone always talks about this, but take small steps to success. And this absolutely goes for your communication and your marketing. I always bring up the example of Facebook, which was founded in a dorm room in Harvard. Mark Zuckerberg's first market was one college in Harvard. It was not the entire population of the world. With startups, it's exactly the same thing. If you're expanding outside Korea, focus on one country, not an entire region. And the final tip, this is a good rule of thumb for any communication activity as well. 70-20-10, this goes for social media, it goes if you're writing contribution posts, even for your own company blog. 70% should be interesting and valuable third-party content. So content that's really valuable for your audience. 20% interesting and valuable content that you've produced yourself about your industry. So not and then 10% content that is promotional. Of course, you have to add this promotional content to generate revenue and interest in users, customers. But this is a very common way of looking at communication. It's a very good way to split it up. So, that concludes my talk. I hope you've learned something. Obviously, these are all things that my company, G3, can help startups in Korea with. We are working with many companies in Korea, helping them expand overseas. Primarily, we operate in Southeast Asia and North America. So if you're looking at expanding to those two regions in particular, we are here to help. Thank you.
네, 감사합니다. 저희가 10초 통해서 들어온 질문 두 가지만 오늘도 피주님이 활약해 주셔서 좀 감사함께 드리도록 하겠습니다. 네, 진행해 주시죠. 네.
글로벌 진출을 해서 한국 스타트업이 저지르는 가장 흔한 실수는 무엇인지요? 라는 질문이 있습니다. Okay, so what are the most common mistakes that Korean startups do when going to global?
Trying to take on too much at one time. And this is, it's perhaps even more so with companies that we get approached from the US. They'll say, we have a budget of $1,500 per month. Please help us launch in Asia. It's not feasible. We can do a little bit of work for that kind of budget, but it's about being realistic of what you can actually achieve with the budget you have. If you have a budget of $1 million per year for marketing, that's great, but most startups don't. So, think very simple. Think simple steps to achieve a big result eventually.
한 번에 너무 많은 것을 하려는 게 가장 큰 문제인 것 같다고 설명하시고요.
Just one thing quick to add to that as well. Especially if you're expanding into English-speaking markets, the quality of the content that you produce is extremely important. It's amazing how many Korean startups will have a website that's in English, but it's almost unreadable. It's, you know, very poor grammar. It really doesn't explain what they do and what the value is and for whom. So it's really worth spending a little bit of money to make sure that your website, at a very minimum, is written in a clear, concise, compelling, and consistent way.
네, 아까 부분을 좀 더 설명드리면 한국 스타트업들은 좀 한정된 예산으로 너무 많은 것들을 하려는 경향이 있고 충분한 예산이 확보되어 있다면 좋겠지만 그렇지 않은 스타트업들이 많기 때문에 할 수 있는 것을 한 번씩 하나씩 해나가는 것이 훨씬 더 바람직할 거라고 설명하고 있습니다. 그리고 홈페이지를 짤 때 아까 언급했던 4C의 법칙을 좀 이용해서 콘사이즈하고 아주 분명하게 그런 홈페이지를 짜려는 노력을 해야 한다고 네, 합니다.
네, 그럼 여성분께 마지막으로 감사합니다. 네, 저희는 이것으로 2019년 스타트업 센터의 컨퍼런스의 모든 순서가 끝났습니다. 바쁘신 와중에도 참석하셔서 자리 빛내주신 연사분들과 참석자분들께 진심으로 감사드리고요. 김정욱 센터 사장님의 마지막 마무리 말씀이 있겠습니다.
이틀 동안 참석해 주신 것 감사드리고요. 시간 관리를 워낙 철저히 해주셔가지고 저희가 딱 그 시간 맞춰서 이렇게 끝난 것 같습니다. 그 작년에 했던 행사보다 좀 잘 하려고 노력을 많이 했는데 어떠셨는지 지금 모르겠고요. 네, 감사합니다. 더 잘할 수 있는데 하나 좀 저희가 준비해서 약간 아쉬웠던 점은 그러려고 그런 건 아닌데 하필이면 오늘 열리는 창조경제 그 혁신 페스티벌하고 이게 겹쳐버려서 창조경제 혁신센터 분들이 많이 참석을 못하시고 다 그쪽으로 가셔야 되는 관계로 그게 조금 아쉬웠고요. 그렇지 않으면 조금 더 그 많은 분들이 이렇게 오셔서 같이 할 수 있었을 것 같습니다. 오늘 어쨌든 이런 그 좋은 행사가 이루어지도록 이렇게 도와주셔서 감사드리고 저희 그 스타트업 얼라이언스 팀이 다 같이 이렇게 수고를 해주셨는데 특히 저희 그 이기대 이사님이 PM으로 처음부터 끝까지 사실 다 해주셨고요. 그리고 저희 그 스타트업 얼라이언스 팀과 그리고 인터넷 기업 협회 그 스텝 여러분들이 이 여러 가지 다 이렇게 도와주신 거 대단히 감사하게 생각을 하고 있습니다. 아, 박수 한번 부탁드립니다. 저희를 협업해주셔서 이런 행사를 할 수 있도록 도와주신 네이버와 이런 좋은 공간을 이렇게 마련해주셔서 이틀 동안 행사를 굉장히 쾌적하고 재미있게 이렇게 할 수 있게 했던 부산 그 창조경제혁신센터 여러분께도 감사를 드립니다. 오늘 다들 무사히 이렇게 서울로 돌아가시는 것 같아요. 말씀드리려고 했던 거 다 말씀드렸고요. 이제 서울까지 조심해서 이렇게 올라가시길 바라고 인사 못하신 분들 다 이렇게 인사하시고 저희 자료와 이런 것들은 가이드북에 다 올라가 있고요. 그리고 사진 찍었던 거 이런 것들 나중에 팔로우로 다 공유가 될 테니까 궁금하신 점 있으면 언제든지 연락 주시길 바랍니다. 감사합니다.
저희가 명찰 반납하셔서 꼭 기념품 꼭 받아가시고요. 행사 마무리하는 기념 차량이 오늘만 한 번 더 있을 거라.